Let's discuss the concept of charge distribution between two capacitors in parallel combination. Here we discussed the concept in three different cases, in which say we discussed the case one when one capacitor is uncharged. Say this is the situation when there is a capacitor C1 which is carrying a charge plus Q1 and minus Q1 on the two plates. It is connected to another capacitor C2 in parallel along with a switch. That means here if the switch S is closed, then C2 will be connected in parallel with C1. As soon as it is closed, the equivalent capacitance of the system across the terminals, say these terminals are X and Y, then equivalent capacitance will become C1 plus C2 because these two are in parallel. And the total charge on the system of capacitors will be only Q1. On left side of the C1 and C2, total charge will be Q1 and on right side it will be minus Q1. So here we can say after connection, final potential difference across the capacitors will be, this can be written as the final potential difference as total charge is Q1 and the capacitance is C1 plus C2. So it will be Q1 by C1 plus C2. So in this situation, if we know the final potential difference across the capacitor, we can easily calculate the final charges on capacitors, like if it is having plus Q1 minus Q1, or we can write Q1 final minus Q1 final, and if this is plus Q2 final and minus Q2 final, such that Q1 final plus Q2 final must be equals to Q1, because this Q1 only which is distributed between the two. And in the situation here we can see that Q1 final here is equals to the capacitance C1 multiplied by the potential difference. So this will be C1 Q1 by C1 plus C2. And Q2 final here can be written as C2 multiplied by the potential difference, which is C2 Q1 by C1 plus C2. This is the way how we calculate the final charge on the two capacitors. Let's discuss one more case for charge distribution that will make the concept more clear to you. That is when both capacitors are charged with same polarity plates connected together. In this situation, we'll consider a situation when two capacitors C1 and C2 are connected via switch. And in this situation, C1 and C2 initially before closing the switch, both are charged with a charge plus Q1 minus Q1 and plus Q2 minus Q2. That means when we close down the switch, on the left side of the whole system, total charge will be Q1 plus Q2, and on right side it will be negative of Q1 plus Q2. So the equivalent capacitance is C1 plus C2, on which the total charge can be taken as Q1 plus Q2. So in this situation, final potential difference V final can be written as Q1 plus Q2 upon C1 plus C2. Because the capacitance of the system is C1 plus C2 and the total charge on the group of this capacitor will be Q1 plus Q2. And if we know the final potential difference across the combination, we can easily find out the final charges. Say after distribution of charges between the capacitors, if final charges are plus Q1 final minus Q1 final and plus Q2 final minus Q2 final, then we can easily write Q1 final plus Q2 final must be equals to Q1 plus Q2 because total charge remains conserved. So in this situation, Q1 final can be written as C1 multiplied by the final potential difference, as in a steady state charge on a capacitor is CV. So it can be written as Q1 plus Q2 by C1 plus C2. Similarly, Q2 final we can write as C2 multiplied by Q1 plus Q2 by C1 plus C2. Similar to this, we can discuss one more case. Let's continue on the next sheet. Similar to the previous case, let's discuss one more case, that is case 3 for charge distribution and parallel grouping. This is the case when we'll discuss both capacitors are charged with opposite polarity plates connected together. In the previous case, that was case 2, we have discussed when the two capacitors are connected in parallel with same polarity plates connected to each other. Here we are going to discuss a situation in which there are two capacitors C1 and C2 which are again connected in parallel via switch, but the charging is like C1 is having a charge plus Q1 minus Q1 and C2 is having a charge minus Q2 plus Q2. Here you can see if we close down the switch, the positive plate of C1 is connected to negative plate of C2 and positive of C2 is connected to negative of C1. So here in the group of capacitors C1 and C2 in parallel on the left side, total charge on the plates is Q1 minus Q2 and on the right side it is negative of Q1 minus Q2. So in this situation, after connection, final potential difference in a steady state can be written as Q1 minus Q2 by C1 plus C2 as the group combination equivalent capacitance is C1 plus C2. So this is the final potential difference across the system of capacitors. And with this we can write down the final charges plus Q1 final minus Q1 final and plus Q2 final minus Q2 final on the plates as Q1 final is equals to C1 multiplied by the potential difference, which is Q1 minus Q2 upon C1 plus C2, and Q2 final we can write as C2 multiplied by Q1 minus Q2 upon C1 plus C2. Here I am assuming that Q1 is more than Q2, or if this terminal X, this terminal Y, I am taking that potential at X is more than potential at Y. That's why I have taken on the left side the final charge is positive, because X is at higher potential compared to Y. The final charges on right side will be negative. And these charges are such that Q1 final plus Q2 final must be equals to Q1 minus Q2, because the overall charge of the system is conserved.